Subscribe to my channel Your Tech Bro and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications about the tech as soon as we upload.
Hey, hi guys, this is Dhanashekaran back here, and well, in this video we will be just seeing the in-depth review of the Moto G5S Plus that had been launched a month back, and you guys might have seen the unboxing video of this device. So let's make a review on it. And well guys, before starting the review, and I just wanted to thank the Rally for Reverse team and the Isha Yoga Foundation for just offering me this t-shirt. And I just want to talk about this a lot, because let me just stand up and you guys might see this. And well, this is Rally for Reverse, and just give a missed call to this number 8009 8009. Just give a missed call to this number so that you can just show your support for the rivers being that are being wasted, so that the farmers can live happily. So this is a great initiative from the Isha team, and this is the Rally for Rivers, and the Isha Yoga Foundation team has been just spreading this all over India, and I'm feeling very proud to just wear this t-shirt and just come up in front of you guys speaking over to it. So just give a missed call to this number, show your support as much as possible. So guys, without further ado, let's dive into the video. So this is the Moto G5S Plus itself, and I've just divided the video into two parts as usual, the pros and the cons, and I'll just leave it up to you guys. You guys decide yourself whether this device is suitable for you at all deeds. So let's get in, and let's move on for the things that I like the most in this device, that impressed me a lot in this device. The first is the build quality. As you guys can see, this is completely metallic all over, being wounded over this device. This is a metallic unibody device, and so whereas in the G5 Plus or G5 U doesn't have a metal body, where it is being surrounded using a plastic coating. So completely metal, and feeling premium to hold this device. The next is the camera. These are some uniqueness in this device when compared to the predecessor of this one, which is the Moto G5 Plus. So next one is the camera, and that Moto G5 Plus has a single camera, mono camera, and you will be getting a dual camera, the normal RGB one. And the next is a monochrome one. You get two lens in this device, which is both of a 13 megapixel shooter. And next, last but not the least, the price point. Getting on to a device for around 15,999, around 16,000, you get a tons and tons of good features in this device. Well, I have lots and lots of pros in this device when compared to the cons, and I love this device a lot. And guys, this is not a sponsor video. This device is being completely bought by me myself. This is not any sponsor video. So this is just a honest review of this device. Let's just move on to the pros of this device. So, and I have just listed down, so don't mistake me, because I used to forget the points and forget the flow and the continuity. So I've just listed out. Let's move on to the pros. And the first one is display of device. This device is completely excellent in all conditions, either in the outdoor conditions or in the indoor lighting conditions. You get a 5.5 inch HD display, not any AMOLED display, it's just a HD display. But let me just increase the brightness completely. Yeah, it's a HD display. You get to know all the complete details in all conditions, as I said, indoor and outdoor conditions. And you'll be having a 2.5D curved Corning Gorilla Glass screen protection with this. So for a price range of this, it's something just going for peaks. So next one is the RAM management. And guys, this device comes up with only one variant, as this is a special edition one, as you guys knew it before itself. And the only one variant with this in this device, this is a 4GB RAM variant with 64GB of internal storage. So 4GB of RAM variant, something good enough for RAM management. So I've just have few apps being opened and listed here. So I doesn't feel any bit of lagginess with the RAM issues. I doesn't feel so. I have done a lot of gaming in this device, like the asphalt, everything. So there is no heating issues. There is no lagginess in this device, as you guys can see. Let me just roll it up. You can see no lag. Let me just take the scroll bar. Let me just move out. No lag, no issues. Completely smooth. This device is completely running smooth in all conditions. So let's move on to the fingerprint in this device. You get a fingerprint reader at the bottom of the device. That is not a button, and this is a touch capacitive button, but this doesn't act as a button indeed. So you don't just have to place the finger, and the fingerprint sensor speed is also much more accurate and fast than compared to the G5 Plus in the last generation. Let me just place my finger, as you guys can see. I don't want to see the screen because I'm damn sure that this device will unlock however I place my finger in this. So that's one of the pretty good thing in this. Fingerprint sensor is excellent in this device, and you can just add up to 5 fingerprints in this device. So it's sort of a good thing for average and budget oriented device. So moving on for the Moto actions in this device. Yeah, Moto has already Moto and Lenovo combinations are going successful day by day. So Moto actions is sort of a pretty good one that Moto is being followed till now. In you same, you get these things, all the gestures you'll be getting in the Lenovo device also. So some of the few Moto actions in this device are flip the screen, you'll be getting you'll be opening the camera app, and then moving back, shake the screen, you'll be getting a flashlight, shake it again, it will be turned off. And the Moto display, and this doesn't act as a always on display like the Samsung devices like the S7 Edge or the successor ones. And this is not any always on display. At whenever you just wake the device, or whenever you just pick up the device, you just have an eye contact with this, you get a Moto display that simply shows the time and some of the notifications. That's it. Moving on to the next one, you'll be the sensors. And this is the one most important topic, and that I have just pointed while just shooting this video. Sensors is one of the most important aspect. Whenever people just buy the device, they first look into the sensor of the device, what and all the sensor this device has, and whether this device is capable for me, suitable for me, because some might be just traveling all around outside many a times. So for those guys, you really need the auto brightness sensor, or else you have to just go to the navigation bar, you have to scroll the brightness bar, you have to adjust every time. And then so for those, this device is not so. This device has an auto brightness sensor, whereas the budget, mostly the budget oriented device, just they literally cut down this most important sensor, which is the auto brightness sensor. But happily, and the most important thing, you get auto brightness sensor in this device. And the next sensor is around, you get a compass sensor in this device, so something just getting over to your mind, because I doesn't believe this has a compass sensor. Generally, compass sensor is present in high-end devices or some flagship devices. It doesn't just go and enter into the budget-oriented devices, and this device is also having one among them. Same as proximity and some other essential sensors you have. But for me, these three sensors are most essential and must-have sensors in this device. So this is also one of the major points I like this device. Moving on to the next one is the most important one, the battery usage. Guys, this device is okay in the battery life, but you can't expect a battery life more than a single day if you're sort of a heavy gamer, because I does a lot of gaming in this device, and I just get around a day or simply just a single working day. But I'm pretty sure that if you're just a normal user, you can surely get a day and a half of juice being left over in this device. So once moving on for the next is camera. The one most important thing that this device stands alone when compared to the previous generation is the camera. You get a dual camera in this device, whereas the G5 Plus has a single mono camera. You get two lenses in this device. One is the, as I said before, one is the RGB and one is the monochrome. The monochrome sensor, you can just go for the depth enabled ones, whereas focusing the focus point and leaving the rest of the background being blurred. So this is the primary task of this RGB, of this monochrome, the depth enabled one lens does. So let me just show you some of the camera samples being shot in this device, both with with both the lenses in indoor and outdoor lighting conditions, and you guys decide yourself. But for me, the camera is sort of a good and average one, and so have a look at the cameras. So let's move on for the cons in this device. I've just listed out only two cons in this device, and till now the usage in this device is completely took me to the next level, so that I doesn't face any of the cons in this device. So I'll just have a overview of the cons, and if you guys have used this device, if you face any cons on your side, do share it to me comments list below. So without further ado, let's get into the cons. The camera, and you guys might be confused that I have just mentioned camera in pros as well as in cons. So in pros, what I like about the camera is about the RGB lens. RGB lens is something just the normal shooter does, and I am satisfied about the RGB lens. The shooting capability of the RGB lens, it is good in all conditions, but except the low light conditions. Here in the cons, I mentioned the camera once again. It is about the secondary camera, which is the monochrome lens, and there is nothing much use in this monochrome lens as compared to the RGB lens. I'm used to RGB lens, and at times are very rarely I just go for the depth enabled ones. The shutter speed in this device is very slow when compared to the G5 Plus. This is the one important thing that I have to mention in this device as the cons, because For the G5 Plus in the last year, the shutter speed is somewhat okay, but it had been rectified in the future security patch updates of the Motorola company. And for this device, coming out of the box, you just take a sample picture, the shutter speed is too slow in this device. Depth enabled one is just taking around 1 second of time for just clicking the picture and saving. So the shutter speed in this device for both the lenses is very slow. Maybe Motorola will just come up with security patch updates on the shutter speed, but till now the shutter speed is slow in this device, very slow. Let's move on for the next one, is the charging port. And I thought G5 Plus is also having a normal micro USB charge port. I thought, I expected Type-C to be present in this device. Sadly, you doesn't get a Type-C charging port in this device. So that's not a big con in this device when compared to the price point of this device. I just complete end up this video here. And if you guys wanna to have a camera review of this device, please do post it in the comment sections below. And I'll just come up with a camera, completely exclusively camera review of this device. And next, the gaming performance. If you are a gamer, if you want this device, what does this device does for gaming, please do comment in the comment section below for that also. I'll just come up with a gaming review of this device. So ending up here, if you like this video, just comment down below, hit the thumbs up button, and make sure you guys have subscribed to my channel for the recent tech updates to be just uploaded, and a few more good devices to be reviewed in future. So stay tuned, keep updated, keep smiling. Thank you guys.